What's up, everyone? I'm Paletta Alamu, and welcome to another episode of the DNA Download, where we explain the science of genetics so you can live in the know. When people talk about their 23andMe reports, I've heard them use the phrase DNA variant. You probably know what I'm about to ask next. What exactly are DNA variants, and what do they have to do with the world of genetics? Today, I have a special guest, Dr. Kayla Kapper, a product scientist at 23andMe, who can help us answer this question. Thank you for being here with us, Kayla.
Thanks for having me.
So let's just begin with the basics. What are DNA variants anyway?
DNA variants are essentially differences in our DNA. You might have heard that humans share about 99.5% of our DNA.
Yes, I love that statistic.
Me too. But there are parts of our DNA that vary from person to person.
Huh. So a variant is the variation in the DNA that exists from individual to individual?
Yeah, that's right. And our DNA is comprised of a combination of four DNA bases, represented by the letters A, T, C, and G. And one type of DNA variant is called, are you ready for this?
All right, let's see.
A single nucleotide polymorphism.
Woo, that is a mouthful.
Well, SNP for short.
Okay, SNP.
A SNP is a difference in a single DNA base. For example, some people might have an A at a certain location, whereas other people might have a T.
So how do these DNA variants occur in the first place?
Some cells, like skin cells, are constantly dividing. And so to do that, they have to make new copies of DNA, and one set of DNA for each new cell. Sometimes our cells make mistakes in the copying process.
Wait, cells make mistakes?
Yeah, and the mistakes are kind of like typos. Oh. Most of them are corrected by what we call DNA repair proteins.
They're kind of like the copy editors for our cells, right?
Exactly. But sometimes the copy editor misses a typo and not all of the mistakes get corrected. So this is one of the ways that new variants are introduced into our DNA. And our environment and lifestyle choices can also cause new DNA variants to pop up.
So can DNA variants be passed from a parent to a child?
That's a great question. And the answer is yes, but only if the DNA variant occurs in a sperm cell or an egg cell.
Oh, okay, I see. So we've covered what variants are and how they occur, but what do they do?
Well, most DNA variants actually have no effect on us. Huh. Occasionally, a new variant can contribute to a new trait, like eye color, or influence our risk for a certain disease. But some DNA variants can be quite useful.
Really? How?
Well, one great example is lactose intolerance. Almost everyone is born with the ability to digest dairy products, but many people lose that ability as they grow older.
So why is it that some adults can still eat ice cream and drink milk without any issues?
Well, research suggests that most ancient humans were actually lactose intolerant. And thousands of years ago, humans in different parts of the world started domesticating cows, goats, and sheep, and they started making dairy products from these animals' milk. By chance, new DNA variants appeared that made it possible for these humans to digest dairy as they grew older. So these new DNA variants became more common over time, and that's why today some adults can digest dairy products and some can't.
You're right, that is really useful. But truly, my heart goes out to anybody who is lactose intolerant. I love a good chocolate milkshake. Thank you for joining me, Kayla, and see you next time on the DNA Download.